Hi, I am Aymeric Brun from Edge Epoxy Technologies. Edge Epoxy is an open sourced layer 7 load balancer which acts as a reverse proxy. The most of the time is placed directly in front of the internet and takes all the attacks. So over the time we have developed some protection mechanism against level 7 attacks, but to protect our appliances against L3 and L4 attacks, we had nothing. So we decided to develop our own solution, Packet Shield, and its underlying framework, a network diverter. You can notice that today is the birthday of the network diverter. It was first released in 2K14. So to understand how was designed the ND framework, you have to know what are the technical needs of the Packet Shield application. Packet Shield is a per packet based application which submits incoming packets to different stages of filtering or classification. Some stages need a fast lookup on VLAN plus destination IP. Other stages need fast lookups. This first lookup is done to make the choice of the configuration to use because Packet Shield is multi-tenant. There is also other stages which need fast lookups on the subnet sources for geolocation filtering or blacklist filtering. In addition, this application needs fast read-write accesses to some table. Packet Shield is able to learn the TTL values of packets of regular traffic and to apply countermeasure of packets which don't present an usual TTL value. It also handles a kind of state table, a kind of session table. So to do that, the application also need to see the outgoing traffic, the cap traffic coming from the network stack and going to the NIC. For new TCP connection, this application is able to directly build and send some responses to incoming SYN packet with SYN cookies, and this bypassing completely the network stack. And you can note that the application can handle multiple NIC on the same instance, sharing the same table, the same configuration, etc. So this is useful in the case of network bonding or asymmetric traffic. And one other point, this application can provide to userland packet capture without impact on the per packet pass. Here, the list of the technical needs of Packet Shield I have just exposed. And the first release of Packet Shield was done using the NetMap framework, but doing this, we faced a lot of issues. Adapter reset each time we attach or detach a NIC to NetMap. Very slow communication with the network stack due to multiple bonding between the kernel and the user land, and waste of time to reformat some descriptor for NetMap. Also, by default, NetMap drops all the TCP offloading, such as JRO, JSO. So we had to re-implement them patching NetMap and sometimes by software into the driver to reach reasonable performances for AHA proxy. And finally, we failed to scale this model, use multiple cores. So we decided to go back to the whiteboard and to design what will become Endive. So we wanted a solution fully in the kernel to avoid bouncing between the user land and the kernel. we noticed also that the most important for us is the filtering capabilities and the filtering performances, but we wanted also to have the minimal impact on the regular packet paths to the network stack. So we decided to be as close to the link as possible and to directly adding some hooks into the drivers. We wanted also a seamless attachment to the NICs, and we wanted to provide to the application directly the buffers coming from the NIC to avoid any copy. And we wanted also to exploit all the classification information available on the RX descriptor coming from the NIC, such as bad CSUM, different level protocol, etc. So we decided to align the framework on the most capable NIC for this and to re-implement by software for the other supported driver which don't support those features to directly simulate this feature by software into the drivers. For building responses, we decided to use a different outgoing buffer to build our responses. This because we want to reply sync cookies and all the data that we need to build our packet responses are available in the incoming buffer. Doing this, we also noticed that we could work with a pool of buffers, and so we don't need to reallocate or remap the buffer for each packet. So it was very useful. Sometimes the application needs to perform more heavy operation to aggregate some counter to maintain global statistic or to commit the packet captured to make them available for user land or such things. So we decided to add also a hook into the driver which will be called not per packet but per packet batch. And finally, to see the outgoing traffic, we decide to add another hook in the XMIT function of the driver, which takes in arc directly the SKB of the outgoing packet. So this becomes Endive. Here you have a simple picture of what looks Endive into an IXGB driver. The driver picks the descriptor from the RX ring. It prepares the arguments of a callback on the RX with the classification information available in the descriptor. In return, this callback returns an action which can be to let pass the packet to the normal stack to drop it, or to directly respond a packet. And in this case, the driver have to insert a TX descriptor into the TX ring. When we did this, you have to know that XDP didn't exist yet. So for us, it was the most tricky part was to reply a packet directly from the RX pass on a driver. On the other side, for the XMIT, we simply call callback on the TX, which return an action to drop the packet to let it pass to the normal way to go outside. So what looks like Endive into the driver side? In the RX poll loop, for each descriptor of the RX ring, we call the handle RX, and the driver have to handle the return action to pass or let drop the packet. If the handle RX returns a length, it means that there is a response available into the outgoing buffer, and the driver have to send this packet into the TX ring. at the end of the Erikspol loop, we added a callback, Eriksdone. This is the callback called for the EVB operation per packet batch. And on the XMIT pass, we simply add a callback handle takes called directly with the SKB to perform the analyze of the outgoing packets. Above, you have the list of the patches available to add and div on those drivers and the URL to retrieve these patches. The last version of those patches are for the kernel 4.9, which is still LTS but, and maintained. But the HandleRx callback, we thought the prototype of the function to maximize the use of the register and to avoid an indirection using the processing stack. You have six arguments, the end event sense, some pointers on the different protocol elder, some flags containing the classification of the packet, bad set sum, L4 protocol, such thing. There is also the packet length. We used the less significant bit to provide the length. Doing this, the application could retrieve the length with a simple cast. We also provide the VLAN and the protocol. We keep them in Big Indian because the most of the time the application just perform a comparison and we don't need to bswap them. The pointer on the output buffer. And in return, the HandleRx function returns a length of a potential response, some flags containing the action to execute, but also some information to use the hardware offloading of the TXSM. So here you have the list of the flags available on input and on return to have an idea. So on the application side, endive application or kernel module, which defines the free function corresponding to the three callbacks. The application must allocate an endive structure to point on this free function and to call endive register by name with a device name and the address of the endive instance. The struct endiv doesn't contain any opaque pointer. The application use a container off to retrieve the context. If you want an example of an endiv application, there is a stateless HTTPD server. The sources are available at this URL. It is an HTTPD server useful to perform some benchmarks. So quick numbers on a Core i7, which is the typical architecture used on our appliances with four physical cores and eight threads. We dedicate the two first physical cores for the network interrupt. We're using two IXGB cards. And the two other cores are dedicated for the reverse proxy HAProxy. Doing this, HAProxy remains the bottleneck and is able to forward 170K connection per second and 19 gigs of traffic. But in the same time, Packet Shield is able to filter 28 million packets per second using its state table. So why to port to XDP? The first reason is to avoid duplicate effort on the drivers, especially on the part which handle the equivalent of XDP TX action. It's a tricky part. It's very difficult to maintain and to over different kernel versions. One other reason will be to also to upstream the current work already made for some driver which don't support yet the XDP on, at the driver level. And for us to immediately benefit of new driver support. To do this, we decide to identify some similarities and differences at the driver level between XDP and Endiv. So on the RxPass, for XDP, the driver call BPF run prog XDP, which takes in argument an XDP prog, which in fact is a struct BPF prog. But currently, we don't really see how to fit the all the features of package yield could fit into a BPF program. Apart from that, the Rx code is very similar. It is exactly the same point into the driver which is impacted. And in addition, the XDP actions cover the need of Endiv. So we see how to patch a driver supporting XDP to run an Endiv application. Other differences, XDP supports a redirect action, Endiv doesn't, but maybe in future it will be interesting for some Endiv applications. XDP doesn't provide a per packet batch function called per packet batch. It is mandatory for our applications, but it's trivial to add. And also, we don't notice a function called to analyze the outgoing packet, which is also mandatory in our case. So we tried a kind of hybrid approach, POC. What we did is, if Endiv is enabled, instead of calling BPF prog run XDP, we decided to call a wrapper on the Rx callback of the Endiv framework. This wrapper extracts the classification information from the descriptor to prepare the argument of the HandleRx function. It also calls the HandleRx function. We had to allocate a local buffer for the outgoing responses because Endiv handle two different buffers for incoming and outgoing packets. So at the end of the HandleRx, if a response is available for the POC, we mem copy the response from the local buffer to the XDP buff. We had also to re-implement the TCP checksum by software because for the NDF application, we use the hardware offloading. And at the end, we just had to map the NDF action to the XDP corresponding one. And finally, we added the two missing callbacks, RxDone and HandleTakes, which are mandatory for the Endiv application. So doing this, it works. We are not really satisfied because there is some generic code which access the IGB descriptor. The mem copy on the TX pass is unfortunate and we have lost the hardware optimization about the TXSM. Overall, these changes are very minor and can be easily ported from to another driver. This attempt was done on the IGB driver because it was already supported by the Endiv in previous version. So in a second time, we decide to improve this hybrid attempt, moving the extraction of the classification of information about packet that we can find in the Rx descriptor. We move this code directly where the XDP buff structure is prepared. And with this, the handle RX wrapper directly takes an argument, an XDP buff, exactly like BPF run prog XDP does. So some number about this POC. Here you have different values depending of the kernel. Due to the kernel version supported by Endive, you have the 4.9 plus Endive patches and the 4.14 version of kernel plus XDP and the Endive wrapper with one and two NICs. We have lost few performances, but we know the reasons, and we are still convinced that we have to move to XDP. So a short-term proposal would be to make the information of classification provided by the RX descriptor of the cards available to the program or the application, and also to have a way to use the hardware offloading for the responses. Doing this on the Endive side, we still have to provide some patches to add our callbacks, but it will be minor compared to actual patches. And a mid-term proposal will be to have something above BPF prog to run something else than BPF prog and to store some context or configuration. Doing this, the driver will call XDP on $X or such function, which could be completely transparent. It could be BPF prog or something else, which could be executed. So more than question, we are looking for some help to know how to move our application on XDP.
Hi. Hello. Okay. It's an interesting proposal. So. One thing about XDP, when we created it, I at least had the concept that it would be a generic entry point and the back end could be anything. You could call into C or BPF, what have you. The evolution was not like that at all. As we know, BPF is caught on like wildfire. I mean, it is the programmable component in the kernel, and I think to the point that some people think it will replace some kernel programmers. So trying to extend XDP in that direction, probably going to be an uphill battle. However, I think some of the mitigating factors that you might want to consider. So when you said that BPF wasn't appropriate for these sort of things, one thing to remember is you can always add BPF helpers. So for instance, to do PCAP, maybe that just becomes a BPF helper function, and you can kind of hide complex functionality that you normally wouldn't program in a BPF, but you can hide that behind this fancy concept of helpers. For the new entry points that you're proposing, so the RX done, I'm not sure that we don't have that already. I know all the batching work in XDP, so we can do these batched receive calls. Maybe there's something there. But if RX done, if the only point of that is to call it like at the end of NAPI, the good news is that's easy to put out of each driver. Mm-hmm. So one of the goals here, by the way, we don't want to have to change drivers or the driver API. So if you can reuse XDP API to whatever extent possible. Adding new API to drivers is really a pain. It takes a long time. So we're kind of sparing on that. So the receive path, we already have the hook for every packet in the XDP entry point. The RX done, if it's not there because of the batching, that sounds like something might make sense to add at the higher layer when we're calling into the driver. The TX stuff is a little more interesting. XDP is expressly receive path only, except for when we forward. The idea is that we wanted to get packets as soon as possible within the driver. So when you have a TX entry point in the driver, that's actually very late because the transmit started somewhere up higher. So usually we consider if we want to do programming on the TX path, you push that back to like a socket or the interface from who's sending. So that I think is going to also be kind of a hard sell, how to get a transmit path going in XDP. It's an interesting concept. It might play in well to some of the things that Van's talking about, like if you wanted to have a programmable common queuing discipline like thing that had to be in drivers, that might actually make sense. But I think that that's going to require a general purpose architecture and general purpose use case. So something to think about. If you can push that TX entry point, actually say not in the driver, but push it back up into say a queuing discipline or something like that. Again, if we're calling this from one point as opposed to every driver, there's almost always a win there. So we want to really minimize the amount of functions we add to drivers because we have to update all of them. And that's, you know, we have experience with that. So it's kind of the same story as I mentioned before. If you do something and it has to work with every driver, try to make it general and not change the interfaces. You're trying to leverage that with XDP, but I think that's a good model here. The second point, though, for HA proxy, isn't it the case that you really have to look at the layer 7 data in order to do the job?
Yeah, but what do you mean by
So it's a TCP proxy, for instance, right? And I have to terminate one connection and send on another. So the proxy presumably gets the reassembled stream and can do intrusion detection or layer 7 load balancing, what have you. So XDP NDiv operates on a layer much lower than that. Have you considered accelerating the layer 7, the transport layer, as opposed to the lower layers?
Our purpose was to protect HAProxy is provide an open sourced load balancer software, but also package this software on some appliances. So our purpose was to protect the system against DDoS attack of L3 or L4 types, and not to announce the performances of HAProxy or something.
So we do have a lot of routes on that. So we have like zero copy sockets and kproxy socket map, and there are things. It's a very different style and methodology you have to apply when you're dealing with the actual data on a connection as opposed to the raw packets. But there are advantages that we can talk offline. But I think there are ways to optimize some of that.
Sorry, we're going to have to cut it here. You get 5 minutes penalty box. People can come and talk to you. So thanks. Let's give him a round of applause.
Thank you.
So you get...